10 secrets you never knew about the end. Number one. So we all know the big void in the end. You know, the one that's after the first end island, obviously. But did you know there's a second end void? Now, here I am at around 370,600X. And I'm about to find something strange here. Feels so weird going here. Yes, at this X position and at Z as well, because it's like a ring around the center. And a generation just stops. Look at this kind of creepy flat wall. And this keeps going and going. But if you keep going this way, away from it all, you're not gonna find anything for another 150,000 blocks. Oh, yep, after a long time, you will come back to the end. It's really weird that this just generates, and you can still place blocks over here that just terrain generation just stops from all the way from way over there to here. Number two, the end was originally going to be a sky dimension, actually. But as Notch was trying to figure out how lighting calculations would work, because you know Minecraft's lighting goes from the top of the world down to the bottom. If you want to learn more about the lighting, I actually have a full video on it. But anyway, with the way that the sky dimension was going to work, it was just going to be too laggy and it just wasn't going to work out. So notice that there's no lighting in the end. Yep, we just removed lighting entirely and decided to make it a dark dimension instead of a sky dimension. And for number three, did you know that one of these blocks is an imposter? Or at least it could have been, because when shulkers were originally being thought up, the devs wanted them to be able to camouflage as any block, which would be really cool. But it was too hard for them to code. I know, it was too hard for even Mojang to code, and Mojang's the big, really good coder company. They made Minecraft. Number four, when end ships were originally being made, they actually had beacons in them. Here, let me show you where they were going to be. Yeah, kind of right here. I'm not sure if it was right here, if it was one block lower. I think that right here is good. And yeah, that's why they actually have not only like a hole right there, which I always thought was a bit strange. I mean, like, this hole right here makes sense because it's how you get out the ladder, but why one right here? It just seems like something you fall out of. And that's also why the stained glass is right here. Would have been pretty cool if there were beacons here, but I understand why there's not. There could have been a way easier way to get beacons. But the crazy end ship loot facts, or I guess interior facts, don't stop there. Because originally, when these were being made, inside there was a hopper with a book and quill. It was where the elytra was. So instead of having an elytra, there was this book, and it was just called Progress by Searge, who's one of the game developers. And inside, all it read was, "We will have something else here soon, dot dot dot." And number six, did you know that on a few seeds, 12 if I remember correctly, it's possible to get an end island that has no end stone? It would be so hard to play that world. You'd have to bridge around everywhere, and if the ender dragon flings you off your bridge, you're a goner. It's crazy that this can even happen. Imagine if there was an overworld without any dirt or stone. And if you're liking the video so far, make sure to like and maybe hit that subscribe button. Also, I stream on Twitch every Wednesday and Friday. So if you're looking for a good live stream, make sure to pop on over. Anyway, back to the video now. Number seven. Now, it seems like I do need to wait 3 nights in survival mode without sleeping, like you usually have to do. But in 18W7A, and a few right after it as well, phantoms actually spawned in the end. And apparently they dropped leather too, and apparently they were black. Now, I think I'm gonna leave this open in the background and wait for a few nights, so then I can get them to spawn naturally. Until then, number eight. When brainstorming ideas for the end and for the name of the Enderman and all that stuff, then one person online suggested a notch that the Enderman should be renamed to the Farlanders because of the famous, or should I say infamous, Farlands that were in the game at that point. But Notch decided that he would rather change the name of the Farlands to the End than change the name of the Enderman to the Farlanders. Therefore, they could be called the Enderman in a way that the End is kind of like the Farlands, but on purpose. All right, say you just barely beat the game, legitimately, not with commands like I just used, and you go to the end poem, which by the way has this really cool new texture, which I now I'm realizing it's just a bunch of textures that are repeating and are moving past each other. Dang it! My gosh, young me thought this was the coolest looking thing ever, and it still does look pretty cool. Anyway, so say that it's going by too slow and you're reading it fast. You can hold space and it goes faster. Say you want to skip to like a certain spot and holding space still isn't fast enough. Hold control and space and it'll fly by. Say that you got distracted, kind of like I did, and you want to go back up. You can press the up arrow and it actually works. It's super slow, so maybe don't press the up arrow for all of it, but boom. Wow, a lot of coders that worked on this game. And for the final 10th secret of the video, which by the way, if you're enjoying the video, good job making it this far. Make sure to comment how many you knew down below. Anyway, back to the secret. So we all know and love the end crystal, and you see these kind of mysterious characters written on it. Are they enchantment table text? Are they just random scribbles? Do they mean something? Well, these actually aren't enchantment table text because we actually know how to read it and can translate it. It's pretty cool. But instead, these are kind of just scribbles. But if you rearrange them like this Redditor did, you could see that it kind of maybe spells Mojang. I think it'd be too much of a coincidence otherwise. Like, and they love putting little Easter eggs in there. But anyway, those were 10 secrets you never knew about the end. As a quick little 11th, did you know Minecraft actually made a video that's almost exactly like this? It's called 10 Facts About the End or something like that. Slightly different title from this. But in that one, they only share about 3 facts about the end because they ran out of things. So I found more secrets than Mojang, which is pretty cool. If that doesn't deserve a subscription, I don't know what does. Anyway, if you like these videos, then check out this one about Thieve or maybe this one about piglins, and see you in the next video.